national and university anthem.
The best way is to adopt circular economy. whatever is end of life, instead of becoming a waste, you pick it and you channel it back into the system. So you are doing one thing, you are protecting the environment from this hazardous waste, and you are using waste as a resource. So this is just an example. We are just we watched a drama by some of the students. So this is the video what they have just dramatized. For instance, if you have some waste, food and vegetable waste, if you go to a market, day in, day out, especially where they sell these vegetables, tomatoes and this meat, they generate a lot of waste. So this waste can be converted into manure, and all of this waste can also be channeled, hydrolyzed, and can produce organic manure, which can serve the farmers. And some of this waste can be digested anaerobically to generate cooking gas, which we call biogas, which can be used to drive our automobiles, and it can be used to provide heating of houses, especially in the temperate regions, and we have killing fuel for cooking.
Let me state that this summit is quite necessary, since it is a strategy not only to add value to the Nigerian economy, but to expose numerous ways of transforming economy through packaging and collaboration of economic sustainability. On the role of manufacturers in circular economy, I urge you not only to receive the raw materials, but turn them to finished products for the benefit of consumers in the majoritarian society. I urge manufacturing companies to adopt the circular economic strategies in terms of recycling of waste for the benefit of mankind.
I want first of all to thank the Vice Chancellor of the for extending this invitation to me to be part of this lecture. I consider it to be a real privilege for me to listen and interact with the guest lecturer. The reason is quite simple. I'm someone who is a friend of the environment and also deeply concerned about the amount of degradation going on today in the world, and in particular in our country. Some of these problems we see today may be frustrating, very difficult to comprehend, and as I listened to the guest lecturer, strenuously, he was attempting to see what can be done about protecting the environment, what we can do to recycle our waste and turn the waste into wealth. This task is not an easy one. It's a very difficult task. It has to do with the nature of our people and the way they treat the environment. Let me take us back to history a little. Some few years ago, maybe around the year 1983 or 84, and close up to 1985, when the president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, Muhammadu Buhari, was the head of state. When he came in with his program, one of those was what was tagged as why? War against industry. And I remember vividly and precisely in the year 1984. Muhammadu Buhari, then as head of state, was visiting Jos, the capital of Plateau State. We were then on the plateau. And the governor of the state then, one day, Commodore Atukun then, and I constituted a task force in compliance with some of the programs required. I was then a magistrate in Jos, and I was appointed the chair of the panel to produce a very clean environment, one that even a leader would not be seen on the streets of Jos when the head of the state arrives Jos. We are given the task to ensure how West can be disposed, both from industries, the markets, private residents, and individuals in the streets. We are asked to ensure strict compliance with what the government provided for the protection of the environment. All drivers of commercial vehicles were ordered to place in their vehicles a waste bin. You were not to throw your litter anywhere but into that trash can inside your vehicle. At every doorstep of the offices, there was a waste disposal container. And we were to go into any industries then, in just, I remember NASCO and the others were the three industries that were in the city to see how they were disposing their waste. A day before the arrival of the head of state, we were going around us and we met with the military governor somewhere downtown in Jos, around precisely 5 p.m. in the afternoon. And His Excellency said to me, said, "Magistrate, I've gone around Jos. I have looked at all our drainages. I have looked at where waste are disposed. I have not seen a single meter in Jos. Thank you very much." Of course, one may ask, how did that happen? It was under a military government, so there was sufficient degree of coercion, force. But I want to say that in my view, maybe that is the language that our people understand better. You may listen to the lecturer strenuously. All efforts that is put down, right from compliance with international conventions, the laws, everything is there. Very adequate, comprehensive. We have listened. We thank the Vice Chancellor for creating this opportunity. Good thanks to all my team. And we have people like Professor Jauro, the charge of NESREA, and other government agencies that will help us out. But I think the responsibility is all ours. That is exactly why, which is one of the biggest in Nigeria, is about to be commissioned by His Excellency, the Governor of the State, and the Secretary to the Government of the Federation. Very soon, the dead will be appointed. I wish that our guest lecturer would find time to go and look at the work that is done in a place that is traditional to me, not very far away from Lafia, about 5 kilometers away from here. We are hoping from the experts that work on that tool that that plant is capable of taking out about 20,000 youth out of our streets so they engage on a daily basis, find something that they can help their life. So,
these are the benefits of that. And they tell you just about that. And if you want to maintain the standards expected of this 21st century, they emphasize the issue of politics. They emphasize ethnicity. They emphasize religion. In educational development, there is nothing like tribe, like religion. We want to see a better people. That's the essence of the public lecture. And he hopes that he will be organizing more of this. He hopes to at least listening to more of these public lectures. This is where their challenge is. Their challenge is on how to really come together. Of course, research is not about one or most research is in team. Put your heads together in various ways and see how you can turn this university passionately. That is the whole essence. And sincerely hope that God will actually give you the vision.
It's a west side. What are you trying to do?
Yes, it is compacted, the sawdust, even the rice stalks. We have something like this. Compacted. Since now, if you look at how we cut out this, we use charcoal.
As this charcoal is a problem?
Very soon. You
will go to Kefi. Anytime after, their movement is after 6 p.m. Entering Abuja, if you sit there, you can count over 100 trucks. And in each truck, you have found not less than 10 trees, or even more. And that's why I told the government, there are certain powers of ours in the country. We were in charge of, you know, fairly the environment. And all, you know, the forest around as supervised and represented by the area. You cannot fell a tree unless you have a license given to you.
Yes.
Those of them in timber were regulating it. Those powers were taken away. And so, and this has also contributed to some of the challenges we have today. When we're managing the forest, there's no criminal that can find an abode in the forest. No, no way. Because our rangers, they are there. As soon as they notice any strange movement, they report. But most of these places are no longer manned. Our rangers died. You know, Serkindaji is only in name now. It's not there. But when you return certain things, it's not too late. Something can still be done.
We have to move very fast.
It's very fast now.
Presently, Nigeria has the highest rate of deforestation. Our forest is going at the rate of 3.5% annually.
We have to do something. We have very fast.
Very fast. About 350,000, 400,000 hectares.
Gone.
Annually.
This charcoal thing, if there's anything anybody can do about it,
so the unfortunate thing now, the price of gas.
That's another problem.
Government must come and subsidize them.
The problem is
global warming.
Another problem.
Yes, when you cut down the trees, certainly you're not going to be carbon sink. That's not really. So continue to go. Thank you very much.
Sorry.